Of Dhanuka Agritech with us. Mr. M.K. Dhanuka, the CEO of the company, is joining us now. Mr. Dhanuka, good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, I remember the last time we had spoken to you, you did indicate that quarter four has not been as good as you expected. Can you give us a sense of what is the status now? How has quarter one of FY24, it's barely been 15 days, but how has it been till now? And with the IMD forecasting normal rains, what is the indication of demand?
Yeah, IMD has forecasted normal monsoon, that is 96% of the long period average, and SkyMet has forecasted 94%. So although the SkyMet forecast is little less, but I don't foresee that it will have any major impact on the agriculture and sowing. So overall, we don't see any degrowth in the demand of the agrochemicals, because ultimately farmer has to do his earning from the agriculture, and if agriculture is there, the consumption of the pesticides is going to be there. April month is basically the lean month period, where only the some sowing which is in the summer season is there. So some sales are there, but definitely it is not the peak season time. Once the monsoon comes, then the peak season will start, and only then we will come to know about the demand and supply situation.
Sir, but just for the period in which we had those unseasonal waves, heat wave, was demand impacted for a matter of 2 to 3 weeks? And if yes, could you quantify it?
No, during the last March month and the first week of April, demand was as usual. Because of the heat wave, it has not impacted the demand. And going forward also, I don't foresee that there should be any problem in demand generation.
Okay, so you are saying that quarter four was impacted because of unseasonal rains or heat wave, but quarter one will see some recovery, and the weather conditions are normal now. So demand is going to be stable or maybe slightly improve. Am I getting that correct after April?
Yeah, because the unseasonal rain came in the later part of the season when the crop was on the harvesting position. So it has impacted to some extent, especially the wheat crop. But overall, still the government is expecting all-time record production of the wheat, and they hope that they are going to purchase the all-time high-level wheat procurement. So I don't foresee that in coming months also, once the monsoon comes, then definitely demand generation will start, and overall we are expecting double-digit growth in the FY24 ending.
Double-digit growth for FY24 end. What about raw material prices? How have they panned out?
Yeah, raw material prices are on the reducing trend. Every month we are reducing the prices of our brands also, as per the reduction in the prices of raw material. And still they are declining month on month basis. And every month we are reducing and passing on the benefit to the farmer.
So Mr. Dhanuka, on an average, how much have prices declined for raw materials so far in this year? How much have you been able to pass on to the farmers in terms of percentage?
It depends product to product. And yeah. In glyphosate, the prices has come down to the tune of 50%. So from 1,000 rupees, the prices has come down less than 500 rupees for the raw material. So in some cases, it is 50%. 30%, 20%, 10%. So on an average, you can say that the prices would have fallen from 15 to 20%.
15 to 20%. And have you passed on the entire benefit and reduced your own output prices by 15 to 20%?
Yeah, definitely. Then this is happening in generic products only. The specialty molecules which we are importing from Japan, there the competition less, and there is no impact of the price reduction. usually there is no increase also and there is no decrease also. But in generics, when the market demand is higher and supply is less, the prices increases. And when the demand is less and the supply is also less, so then in that case, the prices are on the reducing trend.
We get that, sir. Can you give us a sense of what's the split between generic and specialized molecules for you? Is the specialized part a bigger kitty of overall revenues?
No, around 50-50, you can say 50% is generic and 50% is specialty.
Okay. So with the cut that you've seen in raw material prices and some of it you've passed on as well, what is the margin outlook? Because quarter three did see a decline. You were hovering around the 13% mark. FY22 margins stood at 18%. What is the outlook for FY24 in this case?
We are looking at improvement of 200 pips for FY24 over FY23. So 200 bps margin improvement we are definitely looking for the current financial year.
Okay. How has exports been for you? You recently got into the export market. What are the numbers looking like in terms of sales, the run rate?
It is at an infant stage, you can say startup basically. So it will take some time to increase the export. But definitely, we are getting good inquiries and in the very first year, we are able to do 5 consignments exports. And we do hope once our Dahej plant will start, then we will be able to make exports of the technical grade pesticides also. Because major exports is happening of technicals, not of the formulations.
Sir, the Dahej plant was supposed to be commissioned in March, right? It has been delayed a bit. By when do you expect it to be commissioned? Why the delay? And once the exports start, what kind of revenue opportunity are you seeing at peak capacity utilization here?
We hope that the plant, Dahej plant will start production from July 2023 onwards. And once the production from there it starts, it will take some time in exports because we are looking for some, you can say, technical tie-up with some of the Japanese companies. And once that tie-up happens, only then the major exports will start from the Dahej plant. Initially, we are going with the generics only. And for export also, we have to register the product in the particular country. Like in India, if we are importing, we have to register from Central Insecticide Board, Faridabad, Ministry of Agriculture. So similarly, in other countries, we will have to basically register our product for making exports. So once that will happen, then the major exports will start.
Mr. Dhanuka, we'll leave it at that. Thank you very much for joining in. So the outlook demand continues to remain intact, guiding for a double-digit growth for FY24. Raw material prices have come down quite significantly, 15-20%. Exports are still in its infancy. Get into a break. On the other side, we'll talk more about the markets.